this rental complex had lost their son. He's been spotted in Hillbrow taking drugs and that. So we come out to have here. We've got a picture of him trying to get some information from the guys to see if they've actually seen him here, so that we can actually pick him up and take him back.
Who do you think you are?
Where do you think you're going? Come here, open it. Get out your car. Come. What are you doing here, man?
When we approach him and we try to stop him, this guy speeds off.
He's car looking at it. Look at it, chief. He's definitely looking. He could have dropped some guys off.
What the f*** are you doing here?
Put your hands up!
Zane's creeping in, I'm coming in from the right hand side, covering him from behind. It's dark, we can't see a thing. Next thing from the window. I was in the control room checking out things. Dave gets a call for a suspicious vehicle in our neighborhood.
What is it?
It's a small white car, the windows are broken, and then it's just left there about the road.
Where?
Along Kingfisher, Park Kingfisher, and Alexander.
So we decide to take the call.
We often get these complaints about suspicious vehicles and we never take it lightly because the shoppers around, they like to lift off the gates off rails and break into their houses.
Just like that, yeah?
Yeah, that's all, come.
Who are you?
What are you doing in this area?
I'm the lord of this area.
No, you're not. You don't belong here.
I'm the lord of this area.
Don't get clever, my friend.
We'll
arrest you quickly.
I'm telling you.
I'll come and I'll check your cards, okay?
What?
Don't get clever.
Who are you? Who do you think you are?
Where do you think you're going? Come here, open it. Get out your car. Come. What are you doing here, man?
When we approach him and we try to stop him, this guy speeds off.
So we just scratch his ankle. He's very suspicious. He's car looking at an attitude. He's definitely looking. He could have dropped some guys before.
I can just look at him. We're thinking straight away, man, this guy's got something to hide. He's broken in somewhere. He's got a TV in the back of his car. He's done something. There's no reason for him to run. We finally catch up to him and we manage to pull him off the road. And we start to ask him questions, and he gets very cocky with us.
Come. How can I help you, guys?
Huh?
How can I help you?
Why are you running? Where are you running to?
Because I'm in a hurry.
Huh?
The time is money. What are you talking about?
You're
wasting my time. What are you talking about? How can I help you? I'm at work here.
He's very cocky, very loud, so now we... be very inquisitive. Why is he so defensive? Why is he so cocky? Why is he so loud? So now we want to search his car.
Just open it up for me.
You have some parcels in here.
No, open your boots. I want to see what's in here.
What are you doing in this area with this stuff? What are you using these tools for?
What are these tools for, my friend?
So for drilling, for this is a screwdriver, as you know.
What are you doing in this area?
I am supposed to be in this area. I'm the lord of this area.
Okay, so what are you doing there?
Yes, I'm working.
Working where? Which house?
I don't work in the house. Working. I don't work in the house. I must be there. I don't have to get the permission to be there.
When people start giving me attitude, it makes me feel like they're up to no good, because there's no reason to give people that are in a position of authority attitude. We contracted by the neighborhood to look after the neighborhood. There's no reason to disrespect us or be evasive.
Just because I've got the white chick there is a problem.
White chick?
Yes. I was there to see my white chick.
Your white chick?
Yes.
Oh, well, that's good for you.
I've got a white chick.
What number?
That's a problem.
He said he was dating a lady that lives in the area. Obviously, I didn't believe him at the time. I thought he's just looking for a story to give him a reason to be there.
Then if you don't want my relationship with my chick, then why don't you remove her from there?
You're more than welcome to come into our neighborhood. But if somebody calls me and says there's a suspicious vehicle and I come and I try to stop you, don't run away. I'm not trying to hurt you. I want to find out who you are.
Okay.
There's many crimes in this area. People are lifting up the gates. People are getting armed, robbed.
I do understand.
So we have to look after these people.
Okay.
We're not arresting you. We have to look after the people.
Okay.
And you know, maybe while you're visiting there, you're also not going to get robbed because we're so busy looking after everybody there. Do you understand?
No, I do.
It's frustrating when you know that a person's up to no good, but you've got no evidence to pin on him. So, in the end, you got to just let him go. You know, where he said he was and what he said he was doing, it's all sketchy. We spoke to the client, we spoke to the person he was visiting, and he was visiting that person, but...
But his story didn't add up.
If you're visiting a person, you should visit the person and then you should go back home to where you came from. You shouldn't cruise around the area. So we'll be keeping an eye on him. Have you seen this guy around here? Have you seen this guy? Yeah, thanks, buddy. We first went to Ponty, which is a landmark in Johannesburg. It's been known to have a lot of drug dealers, and it was probably a sure place where we could find some people that we could talk to and we could try to locate this kid. It's totally dark and abandoned down there. In Hillbrow looking for a kid that's gone down the wrong path in life. He's obviously become an addict, and he got himself lost in Hillbrow, and we went there looking for him. The mission was to find this kid, get him out of there, get him back home safely so we can get him into rehab or a place of safety.
Often when we roll through the streets of Joburg and stuff, we don't like to wear big bulletproofs and have our guns out and that kind of stuff, because you know, if we come in with aggression, sometimes we get met with aggression. On these kind of recces, we humble, we're cruising the streets, we're speaking to the community, we're trying to get intel. So we come in and we're friendly, we ask them if there's any crime going on, how we can help them, and that's how we get information.
Now, Hillbrow used to be a very popular area to live in about 30 years ago. Now at this point in time, it's probably the most dodgiest place in the whole world. Walking down the street, there's just all kinds of gangsters, criminals. It's dirty, dingy. People are always high and drunk. You go past the buildings and people are sitting outside on the step doing nothing. This used to be a very upmarket apartment block. Like back in the 70s and 80s, now it's turned into a slumland. We first went to Ponty, which is a landmark in Johannesburg. It's been known to have a lot of drug dealers, and it was probably a sure place where we could find some people that we could talk to and we could try to locate this kid.
Hello.
We went down to the middle of the building. It's a cylindrical shape, so you can go down to the bottom and look up at the sky.
The estate manager here said what they've done is they've welded the internal windows.
To counter rubbish.
Yeah, to keep the whole estate, the whole building clean.
It's totally dark and abandoned down there, nothing happening in the middle of the building. It's almost impossible to think that the building's inhabited.
I think this is a lot more functional and a lot more clean than I thought. I've seen a thriving community here, lots of families, and I think all the gangsters have moved out, so I think we're not going to find what we're looking for here, so let's move out.
We were blown away actually how they've cleaned it up. There's actually a biometric fingerprint access system. You can't get in or out of the building. And when you go into the apartments, they're all brand new. Afterwards, we decided to hit the streets and go into Hillbrow itself and just check out the local hangouts and that, and see if anybody has some information for us.
Have you seen this guy around here?
Yeah.
Have you seen this guy? Yeah, thanks, buddy. Thanks, buddy.
Sorry, mama. Have you seen this guy?
Thanks,
we walked around the streets of Hillbrow and we were showing the photograph to a few of the street vendors. And some of the people actually recognized the kid. They said he'd been there a while ago, but he had since left.
They said that they've seen him in Yeovil, so we need to go down to Yeovil side and see. Maybe we can pick up some better leads over there.
Dave, do you know where Twist Street is?
Yeah, it's, you must turn right.
Yeah.
And then twist it, yeah.
Okay.
Just turn right and then twist to meet it.
This robot.
Thank you.
Robot, turn left, turn left, and turn left. Let's get back to you, okay?
Okay, tempo.
We were led to an old abandoned church. So we decided to go have a look inside.
The people on the streets have told us that these guys have come to the area to take drugs, they buy drugs, and they move into these abandoned buildings, and then they take the drugs in these abandoned buildings. Let's move forward and see if we can get this kid back home to his mother safely.
It's sad, eh?
While we were looking inside the abandoned church, the stench was so bad that Mully started mock charging. What we saw inside that church was very sad, firstly, and it's totally uninhabitable. It'll be impossible to live amongst the sewage and just the stench inside there. So we found it hard to believe that people will be doing drugs inside there, because it must be easy to get a more comfortable place than that.
Dave, I don't think we're gonna find this light here. Let's move into the park. Let's go check out the buildings we've got info.
Yeah.
So we go outside the church and we're standing on the street corner and we meet an elderly lady, and she starts rapping to us about where the drug dealers hang out and, you know, our Hillbrow's really gone down, and starts giving us some really great information. Then she shocks all of us. I was shocked, I was blown away. I didn't think that place was even fit for humans to stay inside. It's a total health hazard. And yet here's this lady living inside this building, this old abandoned building full of human excrement. And she just seems like it's like another day for her. She just seems totally at home. So we got a few leads, nothing concrete, but it seems we're not gonna find this kid in Heelbra.
We just got a call from Hawthorne Village. Some of the contractors are fighting each other there.
When we arrived on the scene, there was a bigger guy and a smaller guy. The bigger guy fancied himself as a bit of a rambler.
No, just watch out for the tough guy. He looks like he can run very fast.
Got a call out to a petrol station literally down the road. We've been at this petrol station before, we've staked it out before. There's a call out for some guys doing remote jamming. The particular petrol station's got a sensor, and as soon as they use their remote jamming device, the siren goes off and alerts the people at the garage that someone's trying to jam remotes.
I'm sticking these eggs. So we're trying to have it.
I scared off the camera, that's When we rocked up to the garage, we noticed a white bollard, and when we approached them, we also had cameras all on us. They were pretty freaked out by the cameras, and they rushed off again. Those two oaks there, when we put the camera on them, the oaks are filling up here. See this white wonderful archer?
Oh yeah.
When we put the camera on them, they were very nervous. You could definitely see that these guys were the ones that were trying to remote jam. They were up to no good. It would have been nice if we could have caught them in the act of actually grabbing a laptop or something, but at least we prevented it.
Put the speaker out there, because that's the noise when somebody's trying to jam vehicles, when people park to get inside, to go inside the shop. When the guys have got the remotes, the jamming remotes, that siren goes off, so it makes everybody in the garage aware of the noise and that somebody's actually here jamming. So it actually scares the hundred of the people, and the guys actually end up disappearing. Jamming is a new thing that's happening in South Africa at the moment. It's guys have remotes, it's basically a blue little remote that when you try and lock your car, they hold the button down and it blocks your signal to lock your car. So therefore your car doesn't lock. And all the people think that they pushed the button to lock their car, but meantime their car is not locked. And the guys come through quickly, open your boot, steal your laptop, and they disappear. They're gone within 5 seconds. And it's rough. It's happening at all our shopping centers and all our petrol stations constantly. But now, with this petrol station putting this up, it's a step forward. And I hope that all the shopping centers and petrol stations can be proactive instead of reactive.
And my clients were very happy that we responded in such a short amount of time. Would have been great if we got there a little bit later while they were in the act of actually stealing something.
It's quite difficult. The car that we suspected for jamming, it's quite tough. We can't arrest them for anything because the jamming device is your normal simple garage button remote. So it's actually not a tool. There's no legal case against it. So the guys can't actually be arrested for it, else everybody will get arrested for having a garage remote. So it's quite difficult for us at the end of the day.
Jokes, you got a photo of the ridge, huh?
Yeah. Foxtrot.
Can we find it through, sir? So I can put it on the police radio, the CIN.
Go plan.
So I can put the lookout for it.
Zulu 1, come in.
Zulu 1.
We just got a call from Hawthorne Village. Some of the contractors are fighting each other there, so it's getting quite violent. Please, can you help me respond there?
Copy, we're on the way.
We responded to a call to one of our sites. There's still a bit of building going on there. It's a complex, all high profile houses.
Senor Mark?
Are you
I'm about 30 seconds away.
On these sites, we have different building teams. You know, and all these guys obviously have different pay grades, and they kind of try and rub it in the lower grade guys' faces sometimes. And a lot of the time, these guys don't stand for it. So they take matters into their own hands.
Where are they? Where are they?
When we arrived on the scene, there was a bigger guy and a smaller guy. The bigger guy fancied himself as a bit of a rambler. When we arrived there, he kind of just shut up and didn't do anything out of turn.
Hey, come here. I'll send you.
I'm going to go to the house. I want some sand. Then this one only wanted to give this one the sand. Then this one started shouting to each other. Then this one ended up eating it because this one said he doesn't have any home, he doesn't have any. So this one ended up eating.
Doesn't have any?
Any home, wait, that's homeless guy. So that's why this one is eating this one, because this one is saying this one is homeless.
So he called him homeless?
Yeah,
he gave him a clap?
No, he never gave him a clap because they're saying this one he was hitting him hardly. That's why he was beating by the cops.
Beating with the fist?
Yeah, beating by the fist.
Which stand they're working at?
2418.
2418?
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, this kind of stuff happens all the time. There's normally a dispute between the construction workers and two of them all have a go at each other. It's our duty to get there to stop the fight so no one gets hurt.
Two construction workers had a bit of a misunderstanding, so it ended up in a fist fight. The one kid's quite bloodied up, so now we're going to wait for the SAPS to come and arrest one of them, and then one of them's probably going to go get some medical treatment. Did you search the... No, just watch out for the tough guy. He looks like he can run very fast.
No, he's in safe hands.
In situations such as this, both parties get banned from the estate, irrespective of who caused the fight or what the circumstances were. We just set a precedent that says we don't take You cause trouble on the site and you take the law into your own hands, you get banned, and then you need to go find a new job.
Situation's really getting volatile, yeah. They don't really appreciate us being in here. They don't want us. They don't want to send you this whole gang of guys in here.
The plan moving forward was pretty simple. Basically kick the door open, threaten the guys that were in there, basically get out of there.
This is more of a volatile situation than being in the shacks.
Yeah. That's what I just said to him. I said, we're in the
This is the depot.
Yesterday we were looking for a lighty in Gilbra. His mother's one of our clients, she stays in one of our estates. She phoned us panicking. Her son's been off the rails before, he's taken drugs and that before. So we searched Gilbra, and one of the guys we spoke to yesterday actually gave us a call today and said that no, mates of his saw that guy is rolling with another couple heavies. Probably the dealers he's been buying from, and they said no, they pushed off to Tembisa. We contacted our informant in Tembisa that always helps us with operations. He started doing a bit of homework, speaking to the guys that he knows, and yeah, he gave us a call and said no, he knows where the guy is, so we're on our way to Tembisa now. It's not uncommon for these drug dealers to have different apartments that they operate out of. They like to keep moving their product so it doesn't stay in one area, so that the police can't close them down. We're gonna try and get him out in one piece. I don't think it's gonna be as easy as we think it's gonna be, because these drug dealers don't like to let go of these lighties, because the lightie probably owes them about 10 grand's worth of blast. So let's see what happens. Often when we do operations in Tembisa, we've got an informant. We've used him a number of times. He's become a valuable part of the team, and he actually enjoys working with us. We gave him a call and said we're looking for this lightie that's obviously on drugs and he's joining with a certain crowd. He came back to us and said, well, he's done a bit of investigations. He's spoken to a couple of his guys. They know where this kid is. He's in a bad part of Tembisa. So we geared up and we went to fetch him. This is where you find the big time gangsters. They live in complexes like this. You'll watch as we roll through here, though. Check us out.
We'll be there to hold something.
Sure. Oh, he's the gangsters, bro. Clever them. I think we had literally been on the ground for about 2 minutes when bucky loads of people rocked up.
Situation's really getting volatile, yeah. They don't really appreciate us being in here. They don't want us.
Kind of told them that we had to pick up a lightie that's on drugs. We're not going to leave without him. We don't care what happens. They kind of saw that we weren't playing games. We're not there to cause trouble. We're not there to step on their toes. But we're there to fetch our client and get him out of that place and get him home.
This is more of a volatile situation than being in the shacks.
That's what I just said to him. I said, we're in the
This is the depot. It's a much more volatile situation.
This of course it is. Listen, the troops have started to settle down here, so we need to get in here quickly. Let's get the out of here.
How are you, buddy? Where are you?
I'm around. Yeah.
Okay, yo, we're waiting out front, right? Shot, we're gonna make this quick.
Sweet.
Ciao.
I'm saying, it's in there. One flag is big. You need to be careful. I'm saying, do what you have to do. Get that faster. Get the out of there as quick as you can. You know what I'm saying? I'm having your back though. Okay, come on, let me show you the
street control.
Take it easy. You know what I'm saying?
The plan moving forward was pretty simple. We're gonna move through this complex as quick as possible. Basically kick the door open, threaten the guys that were in there, and get the lightie out and basically get out of there. You know, you can't really go in and scope and see exactly what you want to do in these kind of situations. It's kind of, you have to move, and as you move, you make decisions. You know, to go and get intel for yourself out of these locations, you know, you kind of stick out like a sore thumb. So when we do operations like this, it's kind of, we operate and we think on our feet, and as we think on our feet, we make decisions.
We're just taking the kid.
We're not judging anyone. We just want the kid. We're taking him back to
what We're taking him back to his family, bro. Just relax.
What's wrong with you guys?
We're not joking anyway. Just relax.
JP had our backs covered. The two gentlemen rushed out of the apartment to try and see if they could grab their little victim or their little drug mule back. JP covered our backs and basically told the guys if they make a move, they finished. They could see he had that look in his eye. He wasn't f***ing around.
Hey, f*** you guys!
I'm not playing.
F*** you! For f*** sake, come here, get our niggas here.
Just relax, calm down, boys. We're not here to
fuck you.
Woody, move, Woody, move.
Go.
Go.
Run.
What the fuck?
Go home.
Go, leave me alone.
Go.
Yeah, we basically carried that lighty out of that complex, threw him in the car, and got him out of there.
The f*** off you, nigga.
Go. I'll look up with you later, brother. Shot. This is your little f***. We've been looking in the hill, bro, in Tempe, so we're looking, stretching the whole country for you because you want to do what? Take drugs. Your mother's worried about you and you little piece of
my mother, drugs. Shut up.
Listen, lighty, lucky you're not my lighty because I'll you up.
Lucky we didn't find you dead there.
You fucking drug age, me off, you little piece of irritate me.
I've got a serious problem against these lighties that make bad decisions and take drugs and continue to take drugs and put their families through hell. I've never wanted to slap someone so bad in my life. That lighty needed the beaten out of him because, you know, the arrogance and the I don't give a stuff attitude doesn't roll with me.
Yeah, these guys aren't going to take it nicely, so they've mobilized the troops by now, so we've got to get out of this place very quickly. Yeah, we don't want to be here when the sun goes down.
I was brought up in a disciplined home where you respect your family, our father and our mother. You know, and these lighties that make these choices, fine, they make bad decisions, but the disrespect they have for their families is unacceptable. They need to catch a serious wake-up call and pull their together and stop putting their poor mothers through hell.
Yeah, we will roll quickly. If there's something going on, we'll sort out. We'll be back now. I promise you, we'll be back. Give us 20 minutes.
The caretaker had pushed his panic button. Our control room made contact with him. He said that there was a positive break-in in progress. There were two suspects that had been spotted, a white guy and a black guy.
Are the reaction teams on the way there? Let's see who gets there first.
We try and have family lunches as often as we can on Sundays. You know, we try and go to church Sunday morning, then have a family lunch after, and it's really a day for family and relaxing.
Chaps,
I think your daughter needs toilet paper.
One more from Melissa?
She's saying, can someone please bring me toilet paper?
No, I took it. I want the black one, please. You can have a black one. I like the black one.
Wait, give me that one.
Thank you, boy.
Okay, one more. You can have one more.
Hello?
Two. Me.
And it's quite common that we get called out and we need to give backup. On this specific Sunday, obviously a call came out.
Okay, send response. We also know it. Cars, break in.
What?
And where?
That's what happens.
It's Sunday night.
But it's fine. But it's fine, we'll be back now.
Do you know anybody else in the area that
can go? They came, but we're going to go as well. We'll be back now. Relax.
Definitely not.
We jump up and kiss our families goodbye, and they kind of get all pissed off with us, and our wives give us but you know, they know that by making these arrests in the streets, we're making a safer place every day for our own families.
Make sure you guys have to go now, then.
Yeah, but we'll roll quickly. If there's something going on, we'll sort out, we'll be back now. I promise you, we'll be back. Give us 20 minutes.
The caretaker had pushed his panic button. Our control room made contact with him. He said that there was a positive break-in in progress. There were two suspects that had been spotted, a white guy and a black guy. They were loading stuff into a car of some sort. They hadn't seen him yet, so they were still unaware that a response was on the way. Me and my brothers realized that this was an opportunity to make a decent arrest. We needed to give our guys assistance.
Are the reaction teams on the way there? Let's see who gets there first. Often when we have family lunches or family dinners or even family breakfasts, panic buttons go off, call for help goes out, and you know, we stand up and we leave our families and we rush off to help other people in need, or we rush off to go protect our clients' valuables. Sometimes it's a major disappointment for our families. You know, they worry about us, we jump up now, we run into a situation. They start panicking. We take the good with the bad, I suppose. Lucky for us, we spend a lot of family quality time together.
When we arrived on scene, the caretaker was at the gate waiting for us. It looked like he had seen a ghost. He was actually shitting himself.
How's it, buddy? What happened here?
Yeah, there are two people inside in the office there. One black guy and one white one.
They're broken?
Yeah, they're broken, that's right.
Okay.
He then showed us the way. We asked him to open one of the front doors for us so not to be seen. We made our way through the office park, room by room, block by block. And eventually we got to a section of the office park where we could see a torch shining inside in the distance. And we obviously knew that this is the place where these guys are moving through and stealing laptops, TVs, computers, and that kind of thing.
To someone here, they saw both of you. Just tell us where he is, otherwise we're gonna...
I'm alone, my man. I don't know. I'm alone.
Listen to me.
No.
Listen to me.
We can make it easy or we can make it hard for you.
There's no one else, guys. It's just...
Okay, shut up. Will you just hold him? Sam, come with me.
We made an arrest on a suspect that was trying to hide in one of the rooms. Moody marched him out to the vehicle. I followed Moody. I was doing an inspection on the vehicle, checking the license plates and the reg.
Where are you loading the stuff into?
We're not loading anything, my man.
What do you mean? Don't talk shit. So you've come through. Who are you with?
It's just fine. It's just two of us, man. It's just two.
Where's the other guy?
I don't know.
Don't.
I don't know. I think it's gone. It's gone. It's
Must be false plates. The ridge doesn't match the plates.
Do you find
out
their car?
I don't know.
Is it a stolen car?
No, it's not a stolen car. I don't know whose car it is. I don't know whose car it is.
Well, did you just jump in and bring it here?
Yeah, it was my friend's car. It's not my car.
Mully's got the suspect up against the fence. We're asking him where his friend is, and suddenly Zain spots him.
Zain, listen, he's coming up, Zain! Zain, he's coming up!
Stop. Move, move, move!
Zain, what happened? What happened?
Zain gives chase and tackles the suspect, but all that Zain gets is a freshie. And he flies into the swimming pool. I give chase after the suspect. The suspect jumps over a wall. I jump over the wall after the suspect.
Chase has got him.
Chase.
What
the f*** is this guy?
These ankles are broken.
You got any weapons on you?
No.
Not playing in your stomach. Don't have on your stomach. Put your hands behind your back.
There's the keys.
Hands behind your back.
There's the keys to the car. Okay. The suspect underestimated the height of the wall, so when he jumped over the wall, he hurt himself. I jumped over too, and was lucky enough to catch a suspect that had already was already half unconscious lying on the floor.
I'll keep eye on the suspect, make sure Moody's okay with other.
Very successful arrest. Both suspects are in the vehicle. We're now waiting for the SAPS to come and take them off of our hands.
Suspect.
Listen to the domestic violence.
Look at this shit.
Zain loses the suspect, but he also at the same time finds out that he's got a wonderful talent. He can do a majestic swan dive.
It's one of those things I have to swallow my pride and kind of say, well, I missed another one, but I definitely arrest more than I lose.
How's it, babe? We're on our way home. We're all safe. Got our suspects.
Jeff, Zain and JP are here ready. We've got to just see what our surroundings are. We've got a call in from the client that he's heard them breaking into his property. So just make sure that you're cocked and locked up.
Yes.
Just check, it's flipping dark. It's not a full moon tonight. It's dark. Let's see. We've got a client that's got a huge holding where he's got a beautiful house on there, and he's got basically a cottage that he doesn't rent out, that he stores a lot of his stuff, and he's got jet skis in there. He's got a lot of expensive equipment that he keeps in there. That we actually put a full alarm inside there to keep it safe.
That was, this is a big piece of land, man.
We're driving down to the bottom of the property. This place has no lights, so it is quite scary. Different to responding to a complex or something, because there's all lights there and it's very well lit up. This place was pitch dark, you couldn't see nothing. We had our torches out, it was scary. I didn't want to go into that situation.
Let's just see what we're going to do. We're shaping and we can't see them yet. People can lose their lives waiting for backup, right?
We responded to a burglary signal at this particular house, and it was coming from the shed. The client left a note at the control room that he would be out of town for a couple of weeks, and we knew nobody should be in there.
Just be careful and see what's happening.
Watch the top tab,
Zane's creeping in. I'm coming in from the right-hand side, covering him from behind. It's dark, we can't see a thing.